I have made my way to Madurai, my last stop in Tamil Nadu. And from my past experiences, I can tell you that the city is a delight for every traveler who is inclined to understand the rich heritage of the destination. Madurai is called Thunga Nagaram, which translates to the city that never sleeps.
Ooh, you see that Malai there?
But it's not for its nightclub and entertainment, but for its 24-hour market. Historically, it's also called the Athens of East. Madurai is a modern commercial and industrial city. Yet, it has long been on the pilgrimage circuit for its many temples and holy shrines. But to experience some things, you have to be up really early in the morning.
Every time I've come to Madurai, I've always had people surrounding the car, thronging literally, and selling mallipu or the jasmine flowers. I knew there was a lot of history to do with Madurai and jasmine flowers. So here I am at this beautiful jasmine farm, tracing the story of the Madurai malli or the jasmine flowers.
Madurai mallipu is the only flower that has been given a GI tag, a geographical indication tag for a flower in Tamil Nadu.
பழனி நீங்க வந்து இங்க மல்லிப்பூ விவசாயம் ரொம்ப வருஷமா பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கீங்க.
ஆமா.
எத்தனை வருஷம் இருக்கும்?
ஒரு 20 வருஷம் இருக்கு.
20 இயர்ஸ் ஃபார்மிங். ஓகே. யூசுவலா நான் பார்த்த மல்லிப்பூ சொல்றேன். கொடியில அப்படி படர்ந்து வருமே. அது என்ன மல்லிப்பூ?
அது கொடிமல்லி படராது. இது வந்து குத்துமல்லி.
ஓகே. சோ இது வந்து இந்த புஷ் வெரைட்டி. இது
வேற ஒற்று ரகம் தான் அது. அதாவது ராமேஸ்வரத்துல வந்து இந்த செடி அறுத்து போய் இந்த அளவுக்கு அறுத்து போய் அப்படி வச்சாங்கன்னு இல்ல வேற வந்து.
இதுக்கு வந்து நல்ல வெயில் வேணுமா?
வெயில் வேணும், குளிர்ச்சி வேணும். ரெண்டு இருந்தால் தான் பூக்கும். குளிச்சில ரொம்ப குளிச்சில பூக்காது, சரியா தான் இருக்கும். வெயில் அடிச்சா தான் அந்த அரும்பெல்லாம் அப்படியே பெருசா வந்துடும்.
This is a flower, but when they harvest it here, they harvest it as a bud. And you can keep it outside any temperature. You don't have to put it in water. But evening is when it blooms and that nice mallipu vasana, as they call it. இந்த தோட்டத்துல how many kilos do you grow?
ஒரு நாளைக்கு இதுல வந்து 20 கிலோ வரும்.
Spread across an acre, kilos of these buds is what they get on a day-to-day basis. Sells to about 100 rupees a kilo. Right now it's like an off-season time, so it goes up to 600 to even 800 rupees a kilo. But of course the yield is much lesser.
There's one place in Madurai that is popular internationally, the Madurai Flower Market. Every day, over 10 tons of flower arrive at the flower market, one of the biggest flower markets in South India. From this flower market, many varieties of flowers, especially the jasmine, is exported to parts of India and to countries like Germany, America, and Italy.
Madurai Meenakshi and the Mallipu are inseparable. Any ritual that happens every day has to have the jasmine flowers for her. During her annual festival, there is also the chariot, the garlands, everything is made of jasmine flowers. If you look at the ancient literature, whether it is the Mahabharata or Vedas, or even the Sangam literature, there's a lot of reference to the jasmine as well. So I'm just on my way from the farm. We've got a batch. Of course, this is just a small quantity, but there's more in the vehicle there, and we're just going to go drop it off at the store here.
India, 24 hour working market is Madurai only.
Yeah.
No Bombay, no Chennai, no Bangalore. In foreigners coming to Meenakshi temple, first they go to Meenakshi temple, another visit place is flower market.
Yeah.
Because of pattern of Madurai malli.
How much of it is exported to other countries for perfume?
One quintal. Jasmine.
அப்பா ஒரு குவிண்டல்னா
என்ன? 1 குவிண்டல 1000 க்ளோஸ்.
1000 கிலோ.
1000 க்ளோஸ் கம்ஸ் 1 கிலோ கான்கிரீட். தட்ஸ் நேம் தி பெர்ஃப்யூம் திக்கஸ்ட் நேம் இஸ் தி கான்கிரீட்.
How do you think Madurai was that center where you know Madurai-na malli abdine how do you think it came together?
This soil and the water is the best for Madurai malli.
Yeah. Can I take some jasmine flowers okay. from here? Oh, beautiful. Thank you. Thank you. This is probably the most traditional way of buying it. Not just the flowers, but this beautiful kottans, as they are called. They are palm leaf that has been made into baskets like this using colors and as beautiful and rustic as it can be. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Meenakshi Amman Temple, also known as the Meenakshi Sundareshwara Temple, is one of the oldest and most important temples in India. The temple is an epitome of classic architecture with murals so gorgeous that it will take your breath away. Dedicated to Lord Shiva and Goddess Meenakshi, this temple has become a major tourist spot over the years and is often referred to as the Mathura of South. It is believed that Lord Shiva assumed the form of Sundareshwara, the handsome one, and married Meenakshi at the site where the temple is currently located. Renowned for its astonishing architecture, Meenakshi Temple was nominated as one of the wonders of the world, but couldn't make it to the list of seven wonders of the world. During the Thirukkalyanam festival or the Holy Union that takes place over a period of 10 days, the temple attracts more than a million devotees. The history of Meenakshi Temple dates back to the 1st century, with scholars claiming it to be as old as the city itself. The temple also has a concreted pond named Pottramarai Kulam or the Golden Lotus Pond. It is said that Lord Shiva blessed this pond and declared to no marine life would grow in it.
You belong to a family that is associated to the temple. So you would know the legends about the temple.
This is the goddess Meenakshi Devi.
Yeah.
Goddess Avatar is an important one there. The Pandya kingdom, Malaitusa Pandyan and Kanchanamala ruled Madurai.
Yeah.
He has no hairs. He conducts various yaha.
Okay.
At last, he conducts in the Puttara Kamagosti yaha.
Yeah.
In this yaha, bonfire, Meenakshi came out 3-year-old baby.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Normally, ladies got 2 breasts, but she is abnormal 3.
Okay.
The kingdoms are afraid.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, anonymous call said whenever she saw his husband, the third one gone out there. Meenakshi grown up there, ruled Madurai, war with all the kingdom.
Okay.
At last, she went to Kailas, war with Lord Shiva.
I see.
The third breast gone out there. Meenakshi knows Shiva is my husband.
Uh-huh.
The third breast indicates always Shiva is with him.
Yes.
So after that, the Pandya kingdom, Kulasekara Pandya and his followers are developed this temple. Is there. This is a 3,000 years old Purana temple.
Yeah.
Around 1 million square feet area, sir.
Hey, goodness.
14 towers are there, including 2 golden towers. In all the 4 sides, each one tower. North, east, west and south. The southern tower is very highest. From the ground, it is 161 feet height.
Wow.
All other gates are similar there.
Mm-hmm.
These types of pillar in this temple, around 6,800 pillars are there.
Wow.
This one called Yali.
Yeah.
Yali is a weight-bearing pillar.
Uh-huh.
It's a imaginations.
Yeah.
Horse body, elephant trunk, crocodile's mouth, lion's leg and the pig's ears are
yeah.
there. 10% of the pillars are there.
In Sangam literature, is there anything or inscriptions here in temple walls that talk about the prasadam?
See, first one thing you know that in the olden days, the prasadam situation is there. The kingdoms ordered the public to go to the morning agriculture purpose.
Yeah.
From noon to late evening, the people must work the temple.
Okay.
That's why the people given the temple authority given the land for their prasadam is there.
Right.
It's not the
so
temple
it's more
prasadam
to feed
there.
The people.
People.
Mm.
Then in the temple authority given the kungum and paspam there.
Now, will you be able to tell me what are the prasadams that you do on a day-to-day basis?
Regular offerings in this temple, morning samba rice and then puliyodarai and then thair sadam suddhanam. And then sakara pongal
yeah.
and kalkandu pongal.
This is morning?
Morning.
Okay.
Day to day, it's different.
Oh, I see.
So, over and above, in the special day, it's called Atta Vishesham.
So, what are the other special prasadams that are made?
Kalkandu pongal.
Yes.
So, that is it cooking 3 to 4 hours.
So, I will now head to the temple kitchen and see maybe if any prasadam is being made right now. Yeah. Romba sandosham.
Romba sandosham.
Thank you. As I walked in, they're just starting to make laddus. There is ten kural there, which is a muruk again. And adhe enna adhu?
Appam.
Appam. Appam. Ah, okay, okay. Tell me, idhu eppadi neenga pandreenga?
Kallamavu, adhaavadhu oil, yelaka, chaadika, kalkandu, time and kalkandu.
Ah, nice. But modhalla boondi fry pannuveengala?
Modha vandu maavu vandu oil la soodu panniruvaanga.
Okay.
Soodu pannittu திருப்பி மாவை கரைச்சி அதில் ஊற்றுவாங்க. ஆமாம், சின்ன சின்னதாக கண் சல்லடை இருக்கும், அதில் ஊற்றுவாங்க. ஊற்றி அதை எடுத்து ஜீரா, அதாவது சீனியை வந்து ஜீரா காய்ச்சி வச்சுருப்பாங்க. ட்ரையில் போட்ட பிறகு ஜாதிக்காய்
ஆல் பவுடர்ஸ்,
ஆமாம் பவுடர்ஸ், பவுடர்ஸ் அரைச்சி மேலே தூவி விட்டுரும்.
ஓகே. So this is basically besan, you mix it with some water and you fry it in nice hot oil until it becomes like these small bundis, or like the way you do it for moti chur laddu. So this mixture is basically the fried bundis that's been soaking in sugar syrup. To that they've added some nutmeg powder, ilachi powder, nuts, ghee and sugar crystals, the small ones that are available. So that's added to give that nice extra crunch. This is then haath se achcha tarah mila ke, it's become like a nice mushy thing. And then urunda pudiche serve panna venda. So idu vandu neenga weight podanuma? Weight pottu dhaan?
Ama sir.
Oh, okay. Na onnu pannalama?
Evlo
oru laddu evlo gram?
62.
62 grams oru laddu. So, இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு நாளைக்கு how many laddus do you make?
சுமார் 5000.
ஒரு நாளைக்கு
ரெடி பண்ணு
5000 laddus a day is what they make. On festive days it goes up to 10-15,000 laddus a day. This feeling of just having the laddu, there's some ghee there, it's that waft of nutmeg, and you know you can actually smell the sweetness from the sugar syrup. It's there everywhere and it is just